The restaurant we're visiting today was recommended by Bib Gourmand in 2021 at the third year of their business. He's lived a storied life most will never experience. How did he become who he is today? How do you know which restaurant to hit when you got a handful of options to choose from? The restaurant we're visiting today was recommended by Bib Gourmand in 2021 at the third year of their business. And before our story begins, let me remind you that our chef today is very young, only around his 30s, yet he's lived a storied life most will never experience. How did he become who he is today? That would be him.
Shan-he.
Shan-he.
是,沒錯.
And he's in the business for over 16 years, 16年.
是.
所以這個是你很熟悉的吧,對不對?
對,對,對, 因為這個東西它的品質好壞會影響到客人的心情, 它吃下去的那個口感。
気持ち就不一樣。
對,對,對,沒錯,沒錯. 是。 誒,把給給他弄走啊,對。
This is how they do business. They have like a big chunk of money in their pocket.
謝謝.
And when you pay up, this is how they look like.
你今天有一個小幫手啦,來,我幫你。哦,不要啦,這個女生不要提重,這樣子這樣不好。那個,要不然你這一隻再給我。不要啦,走啦。Today
I'm like the apprentice, following a chef, learning about his day, knowing what to do when you're working at a restaurant.
然後像這個龍蝦,我有一點愛吃龍蝦。真的假的?
龍蝦要怎麼挑啊?
其實活的話你不用怎麼挑。
真的嗎?
對,活的話它就是新鮮的。要看鰻才知道它新不新鮮。 澎湖的石老魚啊,這是正石老,價九老。I
only met him for
okay, 這個價格老起來。
15 minutes now and you can already see how much devotion he's putting himself in for his restaurant. We're in a relatively tranquil area called Mingxin Community in Taipei. And as you can see, it's not especially crowded or busy here during the day. And as the sun sets, it gets even quieter. Some local residents have told our chef today to find a better location and not to waste money. He's only at his early 30s. What got him so determined, he must open up his own restaurant when not so many people had high hopes.
<音樂>以前我们所在的地方就是三重，那上林波罗就是咱在地讲的，就是罗马窟啦。所以以前也会有想要这样子的一个感觉，对。那所以以前也会去参加阵头啊。啊，
那后来是怎么决定结束兄弟楼了？
啊，就是在一个某某的一个大哥的一个过世的公祭。 回去的时候是看着舅舅啊、爸爸妈妈都坐在客厅等我回去，讲着讲着就看到自己的爸妈在哭，然后可是到结束之后，我就觉得说自己的爸妈都顾不好，你要怎么跟人家玩？那你就干脆不要。当下就决定了。对啊，就当下就决定了。After
leaving the gangs, Shan-he made up his mind to enter the catering industry under his father's advice and his fond childhood memories of food. But it wasn't easy, and he faced many setbacks along his way.
台北城市科技大学那个时候有一个叫做台德精英计划，类似建教合作的东西。叔叔阿姨，你们有最喜欢的一道菜吗？在这里，
他最喜欢的是茄肠堡。
哦，茄肠堡。啊，你嘞？
海鲜豆腐。
海鲜豆腐。
哦。还有那个。
我喜欢吃那个松板猪啦，还有那个
你在好讲一讲，整张桌子都喜欢，
喜欢啦。我讲你就有这机会哈，去餐饮的哈，因为你本身伊高中也是读迄落餐饮业，结果就无人要请，伊都有信心的，信心十倍呢。哎，青菜买当你，所以我都有兴趣。结果网络一播出来尔，我看伊，我第一摆看伊做啥物事呢？
什么都没有，
什么都没有，连那小小的一间餐厅都不，拢无一个会请。
他那个是，
我第一摆看伊伤心诶。
他发现说怎么这样都没有，
拢无请。
那个时候我就一直在准备要去当兵，我前两个礼拜接到一通电话，就说你的金华酒店没有录取，但是在另外一间餐厅现在有缺一个人，那你有没有兴趣想要过去试试看？我就说好，那我去，至少有机会可以进去，我就去试试看。
As a teenager, he was running with gangs. But after seeing his parents tearing up out of disappointment because of him,He made the decision to seek out another path for himself. Frustrations came his way, but it didn't matter. He's thankful for the setbacks and those who looked down on him, because they became the motivations for him to keep moving forward. Right now, he's got every reason to seize the opportunities.
那时候什么都不会，你就看到你们班的同学，我也不知道他是我们同学。可是那个时候你就会觉得很奇怪说，为什么他们都一直在切东西，然后你就一直在洗东西。师傅不在的时候，我就自己去买了一把菜刀。我就偷偷问师傅说，师傅，我都没有拿过刀，我可不可以切个什么？他就拿了一把葱给我。那师傅就说：“我切葱丝，你跟着切。”我就说：“好，我休息时间我会自己进来切。”我就开始越切越快，越切越快。我就一把葱本来要切到晚上结束才切得完，到后面开始我切一把葱，可能我30分钟就切完。那师傅就说：“好，你好像学蛮快的。”就直接丢一箱葱饼，我就一直切啊，就是搬完碗盘，我回来就一直切，洗完师傅的东西回来再切，
这是你的乐趣所在。
杀完鱼回来再切，杀完螃蟹回来再切，好，我一天就把一箱葱切完了。
哎，越来越进步哎。
对啊，速度越来越快，才成就于今天我的刀工很好。
With his time spent in the kitchen, he knew the culture too well. A lot of feelings and wounds he had no choice but bear with.Thanks to what he's learned from his parents, he knew what he wanted to leave behind and what to carry on and make better. So today, Jin Shang Hsuan has the perfect ambiance of a restaurant Chef Shan-he has ever dreamed for. And now it's my turn to learn from Chef Shan-he who is the best to make my favorite dish, bitter melon with salted egg. Shan-he!
Hey, 你好。
我来啊。林队，我来。
香婷，你好。
Hi.
How are you?
你讲啥？你再讲一遍。
How are you?
He just said, "How are you?"
Yeah.
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good, good. 我先示范一半，然后你再做另外一半。
好，
好不好？这都是最苦的地方。所以我们要把它挖掉。好，因为它最苦的地方跟口感最不好的地方就是这个地方。
都是白白的。白，你都不要白的，完全不要啊！
可以留少部分，因为它这个摸起来这個，摸起来这触感就像摸摸，大家在讲牛肚啊，那个，那这个厚度你不可以太薄，太薄的话吃起来不会脆口，所以我们要有一点点，大概0.3公分左右，对，那我们就是要一刀一刀下。好，那切久了，你们就习惯的时候就可以很顺手的直接切。准备好了吗
？Done with his demonstration. Okay, please don't laugh. Okay, I'm trying my best. 这个我就不敢做了啦。这样
哦。小心哦，我们厨房的菜刀很利。
What the heck am I doing?
可以哦，可以哦。
可是削掉好多肉。
It was only 15 minutes cutting veggies for me. Hard to imagine Chef Shan-he had to cut box after box of vegetables because he made a promise to himself and his parents that he won't let anybody down.
He became a much sought after chef in the realm, unlike his old days. And here's something that will blow your mind. He made a choice to work at KFC over the fancy restaurants.
我讲，你肯德基根本就学不到技术啊！你肯德基，你讲唔是？ 因为肯德基可以调班，因
为你可以休礼拜六，
可以休礼拜六礼拜天。那其他餐饮业根本不可能休礼拜六礼拜天嘛。嗯。那一个没肯德基可以礼拜天礼拜休，礼拜日可以休息，然后要去写那个乙级的，乙级最难考，你知道吗？乙级。嗯。啊，而且乙级哈根本都不可能考上，因为餐饮业没有甲级的。
Chef Shan-he started from humble beginnings and worked his way up over the years to sharpen his culinary skills. But aside from his I will never quit attitude, what's fundamental was the support and love from his family. His parents gave up their business for the sake of their children's life and opened up a vermicelli shop to support the family because it's what their kids love. They are the mom and dad who could sacrifice everything for their children, but once their kids set their goal,They become the strictest coaches.
因为我爸妈已经吃到已经哦，我今天回家了。因为你一个礼拜学一套，你那个礼拜就是煮一样的菜，煮了六天。
他好吃就够了、哦，很骄傲哈、哦。嗯，哎，一千个只要两个，那一次只一千个只录取两个，只有他跟另外一个。
水电有办法加级，就是说它是固定的，线是固定的，你只要照它的线走，很漂亮，就是有办法考过。但是餐饮业最高顶级就是乙级，就好像我们现在这个菜哈、嗯，如果有十个人来吃，有可能应该会有一个人说，
对，他觉得他要辣的、嗯，可是你没有辣，嗯嗯，他要酸的你没有酸，
那我一定打不起，
没办法满足所有。
对对对对，所以说最高顶级就是乙级。
毕业的时候就要开始去了解说我未来要走什么的路，你要走什么菜系。我们学校的老师，有一个是专门在教我们怎么煮菜的课程，那时候他就来我们学校上课，那你就他说，原来名厨可以这么帅，对，那名厨连做菜都帅，对，那个时候我就会很想要接近他。
Shan-he, who has always been passionate about cooking, met a teacher who saw his commitment during his school days.Master Huang Jinglong recognized Shan-he's talent from when he was a student. He would bring Shan-he with him to participate in programs or competitions so that Shan-he can accumulate practical experiences.
当初我都是自己去嘛，然后后来因为Shan-he是丹楼的小老师，然后他的工作的态度啦跟精神，我觉得这个学生可以看看让他来做这个学习的一个动作。在过程当中嘛，他是当我的小老师，然后看他的工作的一个精神啊态度，那还有最主要他是非常尊师重道，像准时守时啊，然后愿意把很多时间花在这个上面，那还有最主要就是他有一个尊重的态度，对，那我觉得这个孩子应该可以再慢慢的来带着他这样子走。
Shan-he's spirit of doing his best.Led to Master Huang Jinglong's decision to invite him to work in his restaurant after graduation. Shan-he is grateful for everything, and people around him are willing to offer assistance because of his sponge-like attitude, endeavoring to absorb any technique he could learn.